All right, so welcome to another episode of Catch a Flight with Pauly. What's up? I'm Paul. Chilling here with my man Matt from Matt's Barbecue. Matt, let's start off with something dumb, man. What's your favorite kind of ice cream? I'm joking. That's a fucking stupid ass question anyway. We're here to talk with Matt. Matt makes the best fucking barbecue in Portland, maybe even the Northwest. I don't know, because I've never had barbecue up in Seattle or Alaska or anything like that.
Okay.
But constantly named hottest barbecue. Everyone drives here from fucking Texas to taste his shit too. So Matt, I guess first off, dude, yeah, what makes you so dope in the barbecue world, man? Why are people driving from all over for your shit?
You know. It's not like barbecue, it's not about like doing things right. Well, I guess it is, but it's like not doing things wrong. Right? Okay. We're not doing anything special. There's no secret whatever. Rub your salt and pepper. We just don't screw it up. You know, and we do it in volume, we do it all day long. And I think that's like that's what we're good at, is basically, you know, you can make one rack of ribs.
Yeah.
You can make one rack of ribs at your house, that's really good, and it might even be better than what we do. But we're doing 30, 40, 50 every single day, so a couple hundred customers.
How many briskets a day?
26 on average, and then we'll go as high as 40 plus. We have catering and stuff.
Okay.
A significant amount. We used to only be able to do 16.
Yeah.
Before we opened this facility, so we should. Yeah. Where we're at.
Tell us about where are we right now.
A new centralized warehouse we have. We're now, instead of like the taco car, the barbecue car, making their own food.
Yeah. So it's your own barbecue commissary, right?
Our own smoker commissary. I call it smoker warehouse.
It's pretty
giant. You should get some footage in there.
Yeah.
So now we can just, you know, we're not no longer bound by the size of the smoker. Well, we still are, but eventually we'll fill these up. But right now we're just kind of like only bound by the demand of the customers.
So
we can have basically, instead of selling out a brisket at like say 3 4 p.m.,
yeah.
Taco car, we used to sell out a brisket at noon because they had such a small smoker.
Yep.
Now 7 p.m., 8 p.m., you could pretty much get most of the menu, which is really cool.
So, what time are people getting going here every morning?
7:30.
Oh, I don't know why in my head I was like, oh man, they're starting at fucking like 4 in the morning.
When I started working, everyone was convinced that somehow I was like working all night long. You know, it's not a good barbecue unless you like
12 hours.
Yeah,
whatever,
you have to cook all through the night, and just like, man, I have to go home. So we have a great little system. We work from about 7:30 to 11 p.m.
Okay.
Total of 25.
But if I go and get some brisket today, was that started this morning?
No, that was finished last night.
Finished last night.
So what we do is basically the way I kind of describe it is, you know, you cook a steak for 8 minutes, you rest it for 4.
Right. Yeah.
That's how you do it. You want the juices to settle and everything else. We cook a brisket for 16 hours, we rest it for 8.
Oh shit. Okay.
That is another secret of commercial barbecue.
All right, don't tell anyone.
You know, really let out, you know, there's all that energy in the brisket, really let it come down to temperature.
Mm-hmm.
We have these great commercial holding things. So basically, the food, it never gets cooled down, it just sits at this nice food safe temperature. And that really long rest is just one of the little small things we do that kind of keep the product what it is.
You guys got to try that brisket if you never have. Is that, what would you, I wanted to save some questions for we're eating it, but like, what's your one go-to you got to recommend if someone only has like 5 minutes to come by your spot and get something?
Oh, brisket.
Is it the brisket?
Sure.
Yeah, and that's what I would say. Although, dude, the turkey fucking blew my mind.
The turkey,
I never had it before until Father's Day.
Sleeping, man.
Oh, man.
You know, it's super, it's probably the best turkey I've ever eaten.
Dude, it's definitely, it's the best turkey I've ever had in my life.
Yeah.
For real.
not a big seller because everything else is more sexy or whatever.
Yeah.
But that turkey
people
is
want the
awesome.
Ribs or whatever.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, yeah, if you don't mind, let's show us around the warehouse.
Sure.
And then we can go try some food and stuff.
Awesome.
Cool.
Let's do it.
Thanks. So we're here at Alberta now. Matt, you said you've never been here, man. How long you
been
in Portland?
7 years,
Okay. But you've been to Alberta Street, I'm sure.
I've been to Alberta Street. I've been to the Big Shop.
Gotcha.
But you know, I'm a simple man.
Yeah.
My favorite bar is the one closest to my house.
Yeah.
My second favorite bar is the one second closest to
gotcha.
My house. That's pretty much where I get most of my beer.
What's your favorite beer style?
Lagers, pilsners, easy rockers, you know what I mean? But you guys have some crazy fruity stuff,
yeah.
So when you're sitting down trying something, you know, I think what you're doing is super interesting.
Yeah, I mean, let's start with the lager then, dude. Right, this is a Mexican lager we did. Cheers. It's called Mosca. I do want to blow your mind with this crazy pink-colored one in a minute, though.
I'm expecting to have some, you know, you can't come to a great notion without expecting
some
crazy stuff.
We got some fucking awesome food here, right? So, Matt, again, king of barbecue here in Portland. What do we got, dude?
Oh man, this is pretty much everything we do, I think just about. We've got our turkey that you talked about, brisket mm-hmm. burnt ends, which is new. Those are super good. Pulled pork, pickles, we make those in-house. Mm-hmm. I believe this is the jalapeno cheddar sausage.
Dope.
Pork spare ribs, brisket, pinto beans, smoked and pickled jalapenos. These are our barbecue sauces. Spicy mustard, peach mustard, warm dip, hog vinegar, cherry chipotle.
What's warm dip mean?
Warm dip is...
Is that a southern thing, dude?
No, there's a restaurant in... their barbecue restaurant, Louis Miller Barbecue, also John Miller Barbecue.
Okay.
They have this like really watery, like warm dipping
is that Texas?
Thing. Yeah, oh yeah, it's in it's in Taylor, Texas. Okay. So about 30 minutes outside.
So, but that's
of
what they call it. They started that type of thing.
I don't know what it's called. I think I just call it barbecue sauce. I just named it warm dip. I mean, makes sense. It's warm, you dip it. But it's really good, especially in this Texas style thing. Yeah. So what we do on that, we render brisket fat, make tallow out of it. We build a barbecue.
That's the shit. People are cooking with that now.
Yeah, I mean, we've been doing it forever. And like, so, and then we'll cook onions in that for about 3-4 hours, and then kind of build the barbecue sauce off of that. So it's pretty nice. It's almost like a soup, you know, if you drink it. And then it's one, you know.
So
across,
should I be doing that? Or
you
is
can
that
do whatever you want. But yeah, it's a great thing where it just lightly coats the meat without overpowering it.
Yeah.
Where some of these sweeter sauces are very dominant when you eat there. But like again, I'm not here to tell you how to eat it. You know, some people say you don't need sauce. Some people say, you know, I don't care.
Yeah.
That's why we give as many sauce, you know, you can have zero sauce or you can dip it all fine.
Bro, that's like one of the best things I've ever had in my life. Seriously.
Yeah,
that's so good.
These burnt ends are awesome.
You know, I do this show selfishly so I can just try new shit and meet the owners and get them to tell me their secrets, right? It's like, so warm dip. Nice. So that's a Texas thing. You're from Texas, right?
I'm from Long Island, New York.
All right. What the fuck am I talking about?
Barbecue's from Texas,
So, all right. So, what's your upbringing like? How'd you get into Texas barbecue if you're from fucking Long Island, dude?
Oh, man. I'll give you the slightly abbreviated thing.
Yeah.
Well, I started just cooking professionally. Let's just put it that. The majority of my knowledge was working in Manhattan. I worked in some fine dining, Michelin-starred restaurants.
Yeah,
really
which spots?
My chops. Walsay in the West Village. Yeah. And then I worked at a place called Oceana, which is
I feel like I've heard of
in
that
Radio
too.
City. Yeah. Yeah, it's a fish place. I'm sure every city has a restaurant
called
Oceania.
Yeah.
Did that, traveled a bit, got my resume up where I could travel, work. I took a job in New Zealand.
That sounds cool.
It was awesome. Lived on the beach making fish and chips at a some tourist place right next to a national park.
Oh, yeah.
Totally amazing, you know, living outside the country. I just wanted to keep traveling, so I got a job in Australia. Went to the kitchen on the first day. They have a smoker in the back that he got from Texas. He's like, all right, I was a sous chef there. It's like, okay, every weekend we're making Texas-style barbecue. And that was...
Was it owned by an American or no?
No, just an Australian guy in cowboy boots. I just loved the whole culture, I guess, and he would go to Texas on every one of his vacations. Without ever being to Texas and having... You know, relatively limited barbecue experience. You know, I've eaten at some good places, but, you know, pretty, compared to what I know now, like not knowing very much, I was put in front of the smoker and just kind of went for it and just really got hooked.
So that's where you cut your chops, right?
Yep, okay. I was kind of by happenstance, and once I started to do it, I just like, that was going to be my thing. Mm. You know, I just love cooking barbecue. I love how challenging it is, and just dealing with wood and how, like, every cook is different, and there's so much to learn about, you know, how to do it, you know? And it is ultimately a really simple process, which is cool.
Cool. So you said every wood's different, too? Is that what you said?
Oh, right. Every cook is different. Every cook's different. Wood, yeah, sorry.
Got it. Do you guys stick with one kind of wood or, like, a special blend?
Yeah, we use Western White Oak, which is the most similar to Post Oak, and that's, like, what you can get around here, you know?
And is Post Oak, like, the main Texas wood or
something? Correct, yeah.
Okay. So that's like, that gives you that terroir kind of flavor, whatever. It'll help you be closer to Texas barbecue, right?
I think a lot of people that, a lot of amateur cooks or home cooks, they put way too much emphasis on the wood. You just want to burn clean.
Yeah.
As long as you can burn your wood clean, the flavor is, you know, people will make this incredibly dry brisket or dry pulled pork and then go, oh, the wood was wood.
Yeah.
Like, you know, whether it doesn't matter if you use cherry wood or oak wood or you get pellets. Okay. If you can't cook it right, it doesn't matter. You know, side by side, if I use the cherry wood versus this oak, you would definitely notice a difference. But at the end of the day, you're just going to taste the smoke. You're going to enjoy it. I look at wood as more of the way it burns in the smoker and my ability to run the pit than its actual flavor. I think that's secondary.
Cool.
And oak wood burns hot, so it's nice.
some good tips, man. Yeah, so for let's do this, right? Since brisket is the fucking like tell all be all or whatever,
sure,
right?
Sure.
Let's, if you don't mind, like pick up a piece of brisket, tell the people at home like what makes an amazing brisket here? Like what do you want it to look like here, I guess? What do you think?
Where do I begin? You know, there's some like from a competition standpoint, yeah, right? You know, a little bit of pull. I think this is really nicely cooked. You want your fat rendered. Like I said, we have a really simple rub. That bark is not soft, right?
Okay.
It's got some texture to it, but it's not like soggy or whatever. So I guess like, and then, you know, again, you just want the fat.
You
got to
try this
through.
Brisket, y'all. Yeah. Okay.
Does that make sense?
It does, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, know, it's a nice bark, like you said.
Nice,
dude,
nice
fucking
dark bark.
It's so tender, dude. It's fucking
tender,
insanely tender.
It should be juicy, and mm-hmm, juice is not water. Juice is rendered fat. So, mm-hmm, again, people think maybe they didn't dry. They think they dried their food out, but in fact, they just didn't render the fat properly. Mm-hmm. So that's like an interesting, you know, if you look at it, you have to look at the product, right, and judge,
yeah,
it properly. And then that helps you make adjustments. And,
yeah.
You know,
want that, you,
yeah,
want that pink, like people say, the smoke ring or
smoke
whatever,
ring,
right?
Yep. And there's all sorts of science that you can read online of how the smoke ring does not matter.
Oh, yeah?
But it needs to be there. It needs to look good. People eat with their eyes, you know. Again, mm-hmm, this is more a professional thing. It's like, well, I know how to put a great smoke ring on it. I don't care,
yeah,
if the science says that, that doesn't make a difference. Like, we're going to make it look good,
yeah,
ideally.
Dude, it's fucking heaven. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
So any of those tips for people at home, I guess you kind of just gave, right? Right. But anything else you'd say about, like if they got a Traeger, like they need to use this kind of fucking pellets,
yeah, like,
or whatever, or something like that.
I think,
because I do have a Traeger and I'm looking for that.
Start with pork butt. Start,
yeah,
with ribs.
Mm-hmm.
Do it many, many times. Don't just cook one. You're not going to get it on the first time.
Right.
Right? You know,
mm-hmm,
I don't know what temperature a Traeger runs out. I don't really care.
Yeah.
But put me in front of a Traeger by the third or fourth time, I'll probably get a decent result.
Okay.
Yeah. You honestly, keep doing it. You know, and then again, just be very, like, look at what you're doing, right? I guess that's cooking, brewing,
mm-hmm,
beer,
yep,
right? If the beer sucks, you don't make it the same way again.
Yeah.
You try to do it differently so it doesn't suck, right?
Yep.
Or you try some, put some weird shit in there and
put
see how, what happens. So,
yeah,
like, you know, don't be afraid to make trial and error. One of our classic training techniques at the carts when,
yeah,
we're training a new cook is, you know, they always undercook it first, right?
Yeah.
Always, because they're afraid of overcooking.
Right, right.
So I'll spend like a night with them. I'm like, okay, we're going to cook the shit out of these biscuits. We're going to overcook every single one. And then it's like now they have their barrier. They have their,
right,
low end and their high end, and then they can start to dial it in, right? But normally, you know, so I try to set them with like, okay, see, if you cook it this long, you get this, and just try to create a frame of reference of, again, like how to hone in,
yeah,
your skills. So I would say, overcook your pork. Undercook,
yeah,
your pork. Then find somewhere in the middle that makes
when
it really
delicious.
When you
overcook it, you toss it in there or what?
No. We don't really overcook it that much, but yeah.
I'm playing. That's the beans, man. Yeah.
If the brisket ain't good, it makes a hell of a taco.
Yeah.
So Matt's, yeah, barbecue tacos. You know, I mean, if we ever have things that are a little off,
yeah,
still tastes delicious.
Hell
in,
yeah,
those tortillas, man.
Yeah. And I was, yeah. So that was something I was going to ask you. It's kind of like, when did you open the second cart, and like what popped in your brain that you want to do that too? Because you don't see many barbecue carts with the tortillas, and you make a fucking banging ass red and green sauce too. Like,
yeah,
you know,
thank you. I was just super, again, like I got hooked on the barbecue in,
mm-hmm,
Australia, started doing my research in Texas. I got super hooked on breakfast tacos and like these,
yeah,
amazing flour tortillas. You know, I'm a kid from Long Island, right?
Mm-hmm.
A flour tortilla is, you know, whatever those tortillas from the grocery store that,
yep,
it was cardboard,
what you grew up on.
Or,
yeah,
Taco,
yeah,
Bell.
Mm-hmm.
And they were totally fine.
Yep.
And then you got into Texas and had this perfect flour tortilla that just totally changes what you think about it. Like, you know, eating this brisket, if you're used to, I don't know, chains,
whatever,
restaurant,
yeah, mm-hmm,
what is that guy, Famous Dave, or,
yeah,
whatever. And then you eat some
I used
of this.
To fucking love Famous Dave.
Right,
I had,
yeah,
till
me
I had
too.
Some legit, yeah,
it was all,
yeah.
But then it was all about the mac and cheese and how many sauces I could have, you know? So same thing, like eating that
you're
tortilla.
You're getting up there with the number of sauces, though, dude. Yeah.
If you only ate Famous Dave, you,
yeah,
want five sauces.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you five sauces. Hopefully they're better, and hopefully eventually,
yeah,
you learn not to use them.
Yep.
But, you know, first-timers, they want to see that in,
mm-hmm,
that part of their... Again, I'm just trying to give people what they want,
mm-hmm,
you know? And that Famous Dave's person does, yep, want five sauces, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, back to the tortillas. I just love a good flour tortilla. Wanted to learn how to make,
oh, yeah,
one.
Mm-hmm.
Figure out how to make one, and then slowly evolve that taco cart business into what it is.
Cool.
Yeah. So what am I drinking here?
All right, so that's the first IPA. And we went with, what's it called? Star Sower. So there's actually a brand new hop in here, too. Nectaron. And it's fucking insane. I don't know. Cool. It's some intergalactic shit. It's some hot new shit. It's basically the hottest new shit. So this is a hazy IPA. This is a hazy IPA. But look at the color difference, dude, right? Yeah, it's insane totally what hops can do.
Yeah.
Most of our beers are brewed, same process, keep the hops in for roughly the same amount of time. But,
right.
You know, it
and this varies, is just dude. More hazy or...
Yeah, more hazy. I, unfortunately, I'm bad at describing this stuff, man. I'm more about asking other people
tastes
questions.
Tastes like beer, you know? I like
no,
it.
No, good double IPA with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. I'm not too hoppy and like, you know.
No, it goes down easy and it's
I
like.
I feel like I could drink three or four of these.
Yeah, and it's closer to 9%, so.
Really?
Yeah, maybe don't crush
drink
it that
three
hard.
Or four, yeah. Mm.
Goes great with barbecue though, man. Like, I think IPAs. I know people love lagers because they're super easy drinking, but like a lower ABV IPA, don't you think goes just as well or no?
For sure. For sure.
So, what do you think about pairing like fruited beers with barbecue though?
I don't know.
You don't give a shit.
You tell me, man. You know, that's
I'm not the sommelier guy either.
Yeah, we're a food cart. You know, I make the barbecue. I can't wrap my head. I'm not here to get that fancy with it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I think whatever beer you like to drink is the best beer.
Is the best one with it.
Best paired with this barbecue.
Let's go. I want to get to that in one sec. Let's go with a rib question, right?
Sure.
So, 3-2-1 style, or just. Keep it on
I go
and
naked
spritz
the whole
or whatever,
way, man.
Naked
yeah.
the whole way.
Again, I want to look at the ribs. I want to see what's going on with the meat. Once I hide it in foil, it's really easy to overcook, oversteam. I want to touch the ribs. I want to feel that fat rendering. I want to feel the muscle breaking down kind of thing. So that's why we go naked. Not for, you know, because at the end of the day, like you said, I want to, that's how you cook it, right? Like,
yeah.
If I put it in foil, I don't know what's happening. And then I could never get that 3-2-1 to where I was happy.
At home, I'm doing it, and I dig it, but yeah, I want to be able to. So, how do you know it's done? Touch and feel?
Yeah, feel. Yeah, there's no thermometer that works for ribs, so. And, you know, once we dial it in, we know we set our temperature this way on the smoker, and the way we adjust the stacks and stuff, that in this amount of time, it'll be kind of close to being done. Those smokers are great. They burn so evenly. You know, we have 30 racks on there. We barely can rotate them, which is, you know, we used to rotate every hour at the old place with the old smokers, so it's like... Where it cooks like a dream. It makes the job a lot easier.
Nice.
As we, you know, increase volume and stuff.
And did you help develop those yourself?
Or the smokers?
Just, yeah.
No, those are from Moberg Smokers. Okay. They're like a big smoker company down in Dripping Springs, Texas, which is just outside of Austin.
Cool. So you said you don't naked? Or do you mean naked as in not with foil?
Not with
right?
foil.
Got it. But you got to rub on them, right?
Oh, yeah. We mop them throughout the process. Which tomorrow,
you do a rub and mop, right?
Salt and pepper is the only rub we use. For
okay. And then is the mop secret?
No, it's
you
like
care to tell people.
Yeah, just onions and water.
Onions
vinegar,
and water.
Vinegar, Worcestershire, mustard powder.
Okay. That's
and,
the top secret.
And lard. There's lard in there too.
Is it pork lard?
Pork
for the ribs.
Yeah.
Okay. But
yeah.
then with beef, you use
the
tassa or
yeah, the tallow.
Yeah.
Tallow,
dude. Tallow. Sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. We just cook it, and then we have a sweet glaze we put on at the end to give it some sweetness.
There we go. There's a secret.
Yeah. So we rest it in foil, right?
Okay.
So we hit it with the sweet stuff.
You take them off, rub it down with sweet shit.
Cook them, salt and pepper, mop them as they go to help build the bark. Take them off the smoker. Hit them with the sweet stuff, then rest them in foil, and then that's how we do it.
Cool, man. That's awesome. Good techniques for y'all at home, man. Definitely.
Yeah, seriously.
Listen to this dude, this man. Seriously, best barbecue.
A lot of free information. can we put this in a book or something?
Yeah, let's put it in a book, dude. All right. What's next? Beer or turkey? What do you care? What do you want to talk about?
I'm just going to keep drinking the beer. We can just
keep drinking
the barbecue. Turkey.
All right, let's go. So here, for those at home, right? I know you've had lunch meat fucking turkey, okay? You've had some dry ass grandma or your auntie's fucking turkey at Thanksgiving. You have never had turkey that fucking has been smoked for how many hours, dude?
Not long.
Not long? All right.
Two, maybe?
This turkey's insane. Most juicy ass shit.
Yeah.
Smoky flavor like crazy, dude.
I will say, there are no secrets, just don't overcook it.
Yeah.
Just don't overcook it, you know? Oh, we dip it in butter.
There we go.
That doesn't matter. But, yeah, salt and pepper.
You can taste the butter on it, too.
Yeah.
Holy shit, it's insane.
Yeah. Thank you.
What sauce would you... I know you don't give a shit about sauce.
Oh,
what would you say goes good with it?
Dude, peach mustard.
peach mustard here.
One day, I wish we had a sandwich shop.
Using this for COVID time. Yes.
Oh yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. Peach mustard with this. Oh no, sorry, that's spicy mustard, and that's the one that's good.
Okay, is that a newer one, by the way?
That is a newer one. Yeah. That came out, I don't know, last year maybe.
Because I get, yeah.
This is an incredible turkey sandwich, you know.
Dude,
what I mean?
It's so good. Yeah.
Put an avocado with this, and that's where you eat it. But if you have extra turkey.
Sounds very Portland of you.
That's what we'll eat at the warehouse.
Very West Coast of you.
As a staff meal.
Nice. Yeah, so that's a new sauce. When did that one come out?
It was a year ago.
Yeah. Yeah, I hadn't had that. I get, this is for everyone. The reason I want to talk to Matt is, dude, this is, I pick my birthday dinner and my fucking Father's Day dinner, whatever, and I get Matt's barbecue like almost every time, dude, for that, you know? It's my special treat, dude.
It's the way to do it.
Yeah. But yeah, that's insane, dude. I love the, which one's the super vinegary one? Was that the
hog vinegar?
The hog vinegar. Yeah, I want to try that on something too. Put that over there, dude.
So, you know, that works with pulled pork. It's really, again,
how's the turkey sell? How's the turkey sell, man?
It's not the biggest seller, but I think, it just needs more champions like you talking about
it. People don't know about it.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And we have so many great popular men. Like, you know, the brisket gets talked about so much that, of course, everyone's going to get the brisket. And there's so many interesting things to try. But I think, again, turkey is...
Dude, if I had to pick two for you guys out there, I would go brisket and turkey, man.
Yeah.
Seriously.
I feel like... try this. And it's always... Even if you think it's too much food, that is, like, such a great leftover sandwich the next day it's totally worth it.
Yeah. Now, things have changed, right? You used to be able to walk up, and I used to get, like, the everything platter, right? And now you can't do that shit anymore, right?
Yeah.
What do you got to do now?
We just streamline operations for COVID.
Yeah.
So, well, first of all, you didn't used to be able to walk up. You used to be able to walk up and then wait in line,
my bad, yeah.
Yeah. So, now... We have this crazy process where we're weighing.
You got the website. You can book your stuff online,
it's all
dude.
Online
that's
now.
Easy though. Just book it online.
Yeah. So we're weighing all the meat. We're inventorying it. It's a whole big thing because obviously. But then what that means is you can order off the website.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, reserve your meat. If you buy it, it's going to be there. And then it says, you know, so you don't have to wait in line. You don't have to wait in line for 30 minutes then to find out that we just sold the last rib. Classic.
Okay. Yeah.
Classic bummer story of you're next in line and then all of a sudden we say sold out kind of
thing.
Oh,
man, that would suck.
And someone drove a long way. So, there's no whole shebang, but now you'll never have to worry about not getting your food. You never wait more than 10 minutes, maybe.
Yep.
Maybe 15 on busy moments. Too many people check in.
Yeah, except on Father's Day.
That was a crazy one.
I'm just joking. Worry, dude. It's the same thing here.
Father's Day was rough. Yeah, Father's Day we had like, I don't know, 40 people picking up at the same time.
No, I understand.
In general, like, people are happier. People like it. Mm-hmm. We're busier than we ever were. You might not notice that because there's no one at the cart. You know, it's just one person waiting for food. Or we're busier than we always were.
Right.
We can pretty much get food from 11 a.m. when we open to 8 p.m. when we close, almost the whole entire menu.
Yeah.
Great for families now. You can pick up food for your family or four, right?
Nice.
You can be sold out or you're if you just come home from work, you're not going to wait 30 minutes in line for
food. Right.
But now you can, like, order at your office or you're not your home office or whatever you work nowadays, or order from the bar here as you're drinking beer.
Yep.
Pop on in, get your food, you're home in 2 seconds.
Get your
or you can sit down at Prost.
Come pick your 4-pack up here.
Yeah.
Don't sit down. I'm joking. We love Prost, yeah.
it's super convenient for everybody. We're gonna do it forever.
Like, cool.
I'm never going
back. Yeah, no, dude, that's a big change everyone made during COVID.
Yeah,
like online order. Do you use QR code? Look at this shit, dude. We got QR codes right here. Sit down.
I wanna do like a kiosk. I think we're gonna keep evolving it.
Cool.
But like we're never gonna go back to the old way, which is show up, wait for 40 minutes, and you might get what you want.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Fuck
which
that.
Is
yeah.
horrible.
Unless you're first in line, then you get that beef rib, right?
Yeah,
are you still doing that or no?
Oh, we're doing that every Friday and Saturday.
I still never had one of those, man.
Well, I would recommend hopping on at like Thursday night at like 9 p.m.
Okay.
And you can order it for the next day.
So
now it's like buying like sneakers online or buying a PS5.
Yep,
you just
got to
be quick with that trigger finger.
Yep.
But you don't have to leave your house, so that's nice.
So, yeah, Matt, one thing I want to ask you about is one of my other fucking favorite restaurants in town, and everyone else's is Eam. Right?
Oh, yes. Everyone else's favorite restaurant.
Yeah. How'd you get involved in Eam? How'd that whole concept come about, dude?
Earl, we did a pop... Well, no, it's for Feast. So we did... Earl was, like, invited to Feast, you know, Feast Board.
Yeah,
like, the whole thing.
We sponsored it.
Yeah.
Not this year, like, pre-pandemic.
We did, he invited me to cook brisket for one of his curries for his like feast event for 1,300 people. So that was crazy. I had like every. This is about
how many briskets is that?
I don't know. I was as many briskets as I could fit in the smoker. Yeah. So this is back when I had like three employees. Yeah. So I'm like, you know, I'm there till like 4 a.m. Mm-hmm. Matting two smokers, putting briskets where you should not put them, you know, from a...
Did you have to close the shop, though, for a little while? Yeah, just for that.
We kept rolling, man. That's why, you know, I'm stubborn or whatever, and also always with that pride of I can accomplish this no matter what, right? You know, that's that cook thing of, you know, oh, I can work 16 hours, like, screw
it's
you.
It's not even a cook, it's a hard worker.
Or whatever,
thing,
you know, so...
It's an East Coast vibe, is what that is.
Yeah, I would agree to that. But yeah, we had one of the other guys came in like 4 in the morning to cook the ribs, and we were just... We don't normally run 24 hours, like I said, it's just too much, but we did for that, just to kind of make sure we had some food for the regular customers as well.
Yeah.
But yeah, we did that one really well. I think 2 years later, we kind of like kept chatting and stuff. I did a pop-up with Eric Nelson, the bartender.
Yeah.
So we kind of worked
shipwreck,
together.
Shipwreck, right? Everyone yeah. Called we Shipwreck Eric or no?
Yeah, we did a shipwreck thing with the Matt's Barbecue. That was actually the first Matt's Barbecue Tacos event. I was like, hey, Eric, I have this taco, breakfast taco idea that I want to like try out.
Yeah.
And we did a pop-up with Shipwreck. So we kind of knew each other in like passing or whatever. Yeah, and then things kind of, we talked a little bit, went to the space, didn't work out, you know, how it goes. And then found a space and it worked out and
cool. To me, it's like a dream team, dude.
Colin Yoshimoto, who's at Pokemon.
Follow him on Instagram, dude. He's perfecting ramen
He's going nuts
for like
on
the past 2 years.
I don't know how he spends his day off cooking food. Like, it's like, I'm not cooking anything on my day off anymore. But,
So he's the chef there? He's running the show?
He's the head chef. We did make him part owner after, you know, because he's such an integral part of what we do.
Amazing. Cool.
Again, he's the glue that kind of put all these ideas together.
Right.
You know, before we opened, I was in there every single day, R&Ding with Colin. You know what I mean? Really trying to be like, how do we smoke meat? And also, how do we smoke meat to make it kind of tie?
Right, yeah.
Right? You know, and I had very limited time knowledge. So, yeah. You know.
My wife's time, man. I can bring you some lime leaves from our McCrew lime tree.
Oh, nice.
If you
want. Yeah.
cool.
But yeah, it's
still killing it, right? What are the lines like on a Saturday night? Still.
To backtrack from the beginning, we came out with these crazy recipes. You know, I thought the food was good.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, but you know, you're like, you know, it's a day before we open. You're just like, oh shit, I hope someone shows up.
Dude. Yeah.
I hope someone likes the food. I hope, you know. And then first day, we're open for five. Like after 10 minutes of being open, the restaurant is packed, and you're just like, how?
Bro, have you guys ever had the pork steak there?
Pork steak is good. We have a new cooker that I'm building to make pork steaks. That was at the warehouse.
Oh man! And they do that sauce right for it too. The Thai green salsa, man, it's fucking.
Oh yeah. That stuff's really good. Mm-hmm. That would be good on a taco too.
Good. Do what?
But yeah, it's been packed since day one and like hasn't stopped. Even with the pandemic, we're still busier than ever. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you order food on a Saturday night.
Who runs that Instagram account too?
I think Eric's doing
it's
yeah.
It's so fucking funny, dude, right?
A lot of, he puts a lot of energy into it, for sure.
Yeah, man. Yeah, they're long, dude. Like,
yeah.
They're funny as shit. So is there a plan? I know we'll talk about your plans next, too, but is there an plan, too, for a second one or anything like that? That you can share?
We're
camera,
thinking of,
so whatever.
Not at the moment. No. Again, smoker space. There's a lot. It is such a beast as it is, quite honestly. And it's just like... we are trying, there's like a spot across the street.
Yeah.
There's like a patch of land, and the landlord, we're hoping to get them to make a little outdoor garden for us.
That'll
be sick. We're talking, there's some expansion.
Well, we kind of talked a long time ago about something
also,
like that, but yeah.
Yeah, also, you know, COVID's not over, man.
Dude,
you know what I mean? Like,
no, we were talking about the Delta.
A lot of people are jumping on stuff, and I'm still trying to, you know, we are expanding too, but...
Right.
Like, I'm still trying to be really careful.
Conservative, yeah.
Yeah, you don't know. Like, you know, and yeah. Like, we already got through it. I don't want to get through it with another build-out or whatever. Like,
right, dude. No, I understand.
So what am I drinking here? What's number three?
That one, you're going to kill. I actually don't even know that one. Sorry. So we're
not
even... This
is another IPA,
it's
got, right?
Yeah, it's Synestia, but unfortunately, my partner's going to kill me. Yeah, I don't know that. I don't know the history
of this
one.
It tastes amazing.
Yeah.
I love it.
You do. I actually haven't even tried it yet either.
I would buy this.
Yeah, sorry, it's COVID. I don't go to all of our spots and try all the beers. Yeah, I don't know this one.
Tastes like beer. I love it.
It might be our one with Phantasm. Some new unique hop here.
Yeah, cool.
It's really good. So props to James Metro and whoever else brewed this here at Alberta. I want you to taste this one, dude, because I don't know if you ever had a smoothie style beer. But this beer is like, it's like 50% fruit. This
really?
One. Yeah. Let's try this. This is Mellifluous 04. Cheers. It's got every fruit you can think of in it. I don't know. Peach, raspberry, everything.
Mm. Oh, nice. Crazy. Mm.
But it's a smoothie, man. It tastes just like a smoothie.
Yeah, it sure does.
I want a 3-2-1 and braise the ribs, but with the smoothie in the middle.
It's worth a try. I think you can make a good barbecue sauce out of it, mm-hmm. That's for sure.
So we could do that, man. Yeah, I wanted to talk to you off camera later, but yeah, about what beer, because we started talking about making a beer like years ago, man.
I will smoke anything you need.
Yeah, no, we can keep it on. We can keep this on.
Yeah, I want to, you just give me stuff, we'll smoke it. Like I said, let's play around. If it sucks, don't give it to anybody, don't try to sell it, and then if we knock it out of the park, let's make a ton of it, because we got plenty of all the smoking space.
It's funny, I hit my partners up earlier, and a couple of our people that make beer decisions, and I was like, oh, you know, we talked with Matt years ago about making a beer. What beer do you think I should pitch to Matt today? And they're like, not the smoked jalapeno one that Matt mentioned 3 years ago.
Oh, yeah. I was just telling him we
got the smoked jalapenos, yeah, but I don't
that
know.
Being said,
it'd be good in a beer.
We take that brine and that's in one of the Eam cocktails.
Ooh.
Yeah, so there's a gin cocktail on the base is the smoked
jalapeno.
Oh,
and most people do that with like a tequila, right, or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. They put other stuff in it so it's not so crazy.
How hot is it, like one out of every 10 will burn your mouth?
I don't know. I don't eat them, but.
No?
Yeah,
one out every
they're pretty
five.
Good. I think the whole process definitely mellows it out. There's a lot of sugar in there. Mm. It's always, you never know until you take a bite.
Yeah, they're delicious. Normally I add a slicer to it, that fucking free-ass white bread to put it up.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's good to eat right after you take a bite of that.
Yeah, for sure.
Right? Mm. How many people do that? How many people hit the white bread button?
I don't know. they forgot to give it to us, so I don't eat it right now.
Do you? You said you always do it?
Oh, yeah, white bread for me, because white bread pickles, it's the way to do it. I think mm-hmm.
it's the
edible
it
napkin,
up.
You know what I mean?
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was
with it. So, tell us what's next for you guys. So, you know, just so everyone knows, though, hold on. Where are your spots right now?
One is on Mississippi.
Right behind the pros?
Yeah,
Skidmore.
Behind pros.
Skidmore in Mississippi, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then Matt Parker Tacos is on Hawthorne, 32nd Avenue.
Here, real quick, sorry.
Moving.
The first spot, right? The spot, Mississippi and Skidmore.
Yeah.
Pros is a dope German bar here in town. You can get your Matt's
German
barbecue.
Beers.
You can bring it up there. You can crush some German lagers right while you're eating that. So, highly recommend that spot.
Yes.
Okay.
Nice.
Hype you up, man.
Tacos is on Hawthorne, and we're about to move that to a bar called the Hinterlands.
Oh, you're moving.
Yeah, I'm building a brand new. So once those cars are done being built, we're getting another trailer in there and just building another one for Matt's Barbecue Tacos.
Okay. You're moving the current taco location.
There's
right?
a new food cart pod with 120 covered heated seats.
Whoa.
On 50th. Between Hawthorne and Division.
Okay.
So right now we're a little bit in a weird spot. It was okay pre-COVID, but now it's, you know, just, I don't know. It's not the best experience for the guests, my staff. So we're going to make this crazy. I'm putting 3 air conditioners in this cart.
Whoa.
We're going to make it like on the heat wave. It's going to be like 60 degrees.
Oh, dude, your staff's going to love that.
And it's going to be next to alcohol, so you can come have a nice little brunch.
Okay.
And you can also, we've got this crazy late night menu I'm making, which I won't hype up yet.
Okay. The AC is not for customers though, right?
No, the AC is just for the staff. Food carts are hot.
Yeah.
Especially
in August, September.
Yeah, especially the heat wave. Mm-hmm. So again, trying to make, building this not only to make a better experience for the guests, but the people that work there as well.
Okay.
But yeah, it's going to be
cool.
Rad.
So that's what
Eam
you have
is
now.
Alan Williams.
Then Eam, right? And then we got this smoker place that we were at earlier, your warehouse.
That's
right?
That's a central
production
place.
Kind of like a commissary.
Right? Yeah, that's our little commissary.
Okay.
And then I'm opening up.
There we go. Yeah,
in,
so what's next?
Beaverton.
So Beaverton, cool. Has that been like formally announced yet?
Yeah, they actually put an Oregonian did an article yesterday.
Okay. Sweet. Good timing. Good timing to film this. Cool. So yeah, where's that out in Beaverton?
It's like Old Town.
Is it the new like downtown or not new?
Yeah, they call it
not
Old
new,
Town.
But the down. So ex Novo's there,
Novo's
right?
There.
There's a good fried chicken
Big
spot
chicken
across the street.
Yeah. There, yeah.
So you'll be
and
right
is,
there.
And this is with Breakside Brewing.
With Breakside.
Yeah.
Okay.
So they're doing a little like beer garden.
Okay.
Basically, it's gonna be like pros, but in Beaverton. So
got
I'm
it.
Super excited.
Oh, cool. Nice.
Five. Carts.
I read they're there. Yeah. And Loyal Legion maybe too.
Loyal Legion is putting a new thing up there.
Yeah.
They're,
so a lot of people are going right there.
Everybody who goes there is incredibly busy.
Yeah. We opened ours in Cedar Mill. It's not in that downtown area.
Right.
Whatever,
and you know, like
it's doing
like,
great. Yeah.
Everybody, we started doing deliveries now for bigger orders. Like, you pretty much just drive out to Beaverton the whole time. and again, all customers just, number one place people want us to go to is Beaverton.
Okay.
So Scott from Breakside, mm-hmm. sent me an email or something, and he was like, hey, I'm doing a thing in Beaverton. Do you want to be a part of it? It was like, absolutely. You know what I mean? Like, because, you know, as just a food cart, I want to make sure I'm partnered with people that know what they're doing. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No,
so, you know, to have, because that is our front of house, right? You know what I mean? So, you know, it's like, that's why we talked about doing stuff for a while. Like, I'm really good at the food side, but I want to make sure I'm with someone that's going to, like, elevate the total experience.
Heck yeah, man. No, you guys will kill it out there, dude. 100%, you'll kill it.
If anything, it'll just be less, shorter drive for all our delivery orders, you know, we'll just have a hub out there.
Yep. Cool. Yeah. And will you still do direct-to-consumer stuff, though, like deliver yourself, or no?
So we're like on DoorDash and stuff, DoorDash. You know, whatever.
Cool.
But yeah, like for bigger orders, we're starting to deliver, so that's our catering.
Got it.
Is like, we'll try to, you know, we only have one truck, so we do like maybe two or three a day tops.
Yeah.
But we'll, you know, we drove out, you know, we're driving out to hour out to do giant weddings and vineyards, you know, like big events kind of thing. And kind of that's our baby step into doing on-site catering.
So got it.
Now we're just delivering. Hopefully by next year we're going to deliver, serve.
Yeah.
What else? Got a big butcher block and slice brisket right in front of your guests and kind of do that.
That sounds sick.
Huge demand for that.
Yeah.
Crazy demand. You know, so we want to make sure, like, if you're having an amazing wedding and you love barbecue, we're going to give you the exact same food you would get at the cart at your wedding.
That sounds amazing.
Is, again, the beauty of catering, so many weddings have terrible food, and the beauty of barbecue is, like, you can do that and get the exact same experience. Yep. So we're, like, really uniquely positioned to knock it out of the park.
Mel and I will hire you for our what do you call it when you get married again?
Second marriage.
Yeah, I forget the name of it, dude. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, what else do you want people to know, man? Like, you know, you're hiring right now, right? Sounds like, just so everyone knows, right? You know, Matt's doing this with his wife, right?
Yep.
You want to give a shout out to your wife or anyone?
Shout out to Tig.
Shout out to your wives, right?
She's not going to watch this. I'll show it to her now.
Yeah, But yeah, they help a lot, man, but you reach a point, you want to get some extra help,
my
right?
My wife had a full-time job, a career. She has a master's degree in public health, you know. Mm-hmm. But Matt's barbecue started doing really well, quite honestly. But I also needed some help. You know, she is very much helping me with the business side. But as we keep growing and the warehouse open, and you know, we just keeps growing. It just doesn't. You know, obviously, it stopped during COVID, but now since March, we've just been ramping up so heavy that now we just work all the time. And now it's like my wife helping me is almost this crazy job. Yeah. So we're finally hiring a back office business manager. Okay. Yeah.
Any other positions?
We'll hire.
Even though we're always hiring.
Yeah, right now, by the time this comes out, we'll be hiring another cook.
Yep.
But right now, trying to really, again, build that foundation so we can continue to grow. Because, like, for me to do, like, I learned a long time ago that Matt cannot cook all the barbecue.
Right.
That was the first thing. Like, you know, it was Matt. In the beginning, I was like, no, I'm the only one cooking. And I was like, no, I'm the only one who can slice. And everyone who gets served by me.
Yeah.
And then you kind of like come to the reality of like, this is, you know, now we are 25 people. Yep. Probably in 6 months we'll be 35 people. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm building systems, making sure everybody is also passionate about barbecue, you know, and just making sure the consistency stays the same. But it's we're getting that way with the office where it's like, man, I can't pay every bill. I can't write every schedule. Like, it's just getting way too much. So excited for the next level of kind of our growth so I can hopefully get even back in the kitchen more and be more on that creative side, because I'm just, you know, you work in the kitchen and you brew beer because you don't want a 9-to-5. Right,
right.
And what do I get for all my success is a 9-to-5 admin job. And I'm like, what the fuck? This isn't how I...
yeah, dude.
This wasn't the vision of that I get to stay 8 hours in the office every day. So now it's time to get out of that. Finally.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Anything you want to close with, man? Anything you want the people to know about Matt's Barbecue future? Yeah. Where can they reach you at, man?
Matt'sBarbecuePDX.com.
Okay.
Yeah. You know where to find us. Just follow your nose, right?
Smell that. Smells amazing, dude. So yeah, thanks for joining, dude.
Hey, thank you, man.
Thanks, everyone.
Pleasure chatting.